Good morning, students. Welcome back to our video. Now we are going to see class 14 standard English, a new poem called The Ant and the Cricket. So here it was written by, adapted from Aesop Fables. So here fables means stories. So here the title is The Ant and the Cricket. So here the ant is a familiar insect, we all know. From childhood onwards we have learned a lot of things from ant. I mean discipline and working hard. It never takes rest. It is working continuously and tirelessly. It can save food for its future. Okay, we all know all these things. All these things are related to our life also. And then the cricket. Here the word cricket means we all know it's a familiar game. But in this poem, the cricket is not a game, but an insect. Okay. So here in this poem, there are two characters. One is the ant, and the second one is the cricket. Let us see the image of an insect called cricket here. Okay. So it is an image of cricket. I mean the insect. It may occur in two colors. One is black and another one is brown color. It has short legs and then it is related to grasshopper. And then it can make loud sound by rubbing its wings. About author introduction. Aesop Fables is a collection of fables credited to Aesop, a storyteller. So here Aesop written lot of stories for children also. And then he also called as a storyteller. He have written lot of interesting stories. And then he believed to have lived in the ancient Greece between 620 and 564 BCE. And then his collection of fables, I mean stories, were printed in many languages. Okay. And then the outline of the story is here. A fable is a traditional story that teaches a moral lesson. From each and every fable, we can learn moral lesson to our life. Okay. And then the poem, The Ant and the Cricket, teaches us the importance of hard work and planning. So here, hard work and planning is very essential and important to our day-to-day life. So this poem also teaches the same thing. Okay. Let us go to the stanza. So here, a silly young cricket accustomed to sing through the warm sunny month of gay summer and spring began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Okay, so here in this stanza, the poet says about the insect called the cricket. Okay, so here, a silly young cricket. So here, cricket, the insect cricket is called as a silly young cricket. So here, so the word silly foolish or stupid. So here this first line the author says the cricket is a foolish one, a stupid one. So a silly young cricket accustomed to sing. Here the word accustomed means usual. means usual. It's having the habit of singing. That is called here accustomed to sing. Okay. So again, a silly end cricket, a foolish cricket, accustomed to sing. Through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, throughout his life, here during the summer and spring season, a silly young cricket, accustomed to sing, is going on singing. Here gay means cheer or joy. Cheer or joy. So it was enjoyed its life during the month of summer and spring. So it's supposed to work hard, it's supposed to have some planning for its future. But the silly young cricket was enjoying its day throughout the summer and spring by singing, by enjoying its life. And then what happened to the cricket beans here? Began to complain when he found that at home the cupboard was empty and winter was come. After that, what happened means here the silly young cricket went to its home and searching for food. And then he went to his cupboard and looking for food because it feels very hungry. Okay, that's why he's searching for food. And then he noticed that his cupboard was empty. There was no more food in the cupboard. It was looking very empty. And winter was come. Now it is in winter season. After that, summer and spring season, it will be a winter season. So in the winter season, it was suffered a lot. It was looking for, it was searching for its prey or its food. But it was empty. The cupboard was looking very empty. During his working time, the silly cricket was enjoying his life by singing and also with very joy. It never had any plan, it never had any hard work. Okay, and then the next sentence on. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. And then during the winter season, it was searching for food. So the cricket need some food to live. Okay, that's why it was searching for food. In the second sense, it is in the winter season. What happened in the winter season? All the ground, all the trees, all the leaves was covered with winter. It was not able to search for food. That's why here the author says, not a crumb. Crumb means a piece of bread. A piece of bread. So was not able to find out even a piece of bread, a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground. So during the winter season, what happened? The ground was covered with snow. It was looking in a very white color. It was not able to find any food on the ground. And then, not a flower could he see. This line, the word he refers to the cricket. So here, when he was not able to find out even a flower, and then not a leaf on a tree. So the leaf also covered with snow, was not able to find out any food for its life because it never saved for its future. Never saved for its future. During his working time, it was enjoying his life in a very cheerful manner. Okay, so I hope you all understood this story. It's a poem, but it is in the form of story. Okay, the entire poem is about the story of the ant and the cricket. Okay, so here the first line: a silly young cricket accustomed to sing. So here in this line, a silly young cricket, it's an insect, it is given a human quality. I mean singing is a human quality. So here the figure of speech is personification. Figure of speech is personification. What do you mean personification? Giving life to non-living things. Okay, so here an insect is given a human quality called singing. That's why it is called the personification. Okay, so here lot of alliterations and lot of rhyming words are there. So dear students, this is the beginning of the story. Starts with the ant and the cricket. It's a very interesting story. I hope you all should understood the introduction and the outline or concept of the story. Okay, you are thorough with all this one, and then we will meet you in the next video.